work on the questions. So les questions, and especially the little words that you will have to use or to put at the beginning of your questions. And the first example that we can see is quand. Quand means when, okay? So let's see two examples. So if you start a question with quand, like in the first example here, quand arrivez-vous, okay? Arriver is to arrive, okay? So vous, second person of the plural. You can use that for a group of person, or then you can use that for one person, and that's the polite way to use. Quand arrivez-vous? And now you can see that we've been changing the order. So normally, of course, the subject is before the verb, okay? But then the correct way to make a question, if you start with this quand, is to change the order. So first to put the verb, then you put this pronom personnel, okay? Quand arrivez-vous? All right, and then the rule is like in French, you've got to raise a little bit your voice at the end of a question. Quand arrivez-vous? Quand arrivez-vous? Okay, make this little link between the two. Quand arrivez-vous? Quand arrivez-vous? All right, and then, well, when we talk, then we normally have this option to drop this rule. So not to use this rule, so just to put the first, the verb, and then the subject after. And we tend to add this est-ce form here, est-ce, okay? So, and you'll get this question. So, quand est-ce vous arrivez? It is exactly the same question, okay? It is quite long if you compare it to the first one. It is more spoken, okay? It is less formal, and that's normally what you'll hear if you talk with French people. Quand est-ce que vous arrivez? Quand est-ce que vous arrivez? Okay, and then here you see that because you've been using this est-ce form, then you keep the normal order. So first the subject, vous, and then the verb, okay? Quand est-ce que vous arrivez? All right, and then don't be afraid to raise your voice a little bit at the end. Quand est-ce que vous arrivez? Quand est-ce que vous arrivez? You see? So it's not really the opera. You don't need to go really high, you know, but it's just a little bit. Quand est-ce que vous arrivez? That's it. And the next one is où. Où means where. Where. Okay, so quand, when, remember, où, where. Two examples, same rule, okay? So the formal or the classic way, if you want to ask a question with où, would be to change the order. So first the verb, then the subject here. Où habitez-vous? Où habitez-vous? Where do you live? Habiter is to live. So you live like if you're talking about the place where you are living, okay? Où habitez-vous? Où habitez-vous? And then same possibility, you just add this est-ce, and then you keep the normal order of the sentence, so subject and verb. Où est-ce que vous habitez? Où est-ce que vous habitez? All right. Next. Pourquoi? Pourquoi is really useful because it's why. Okay, so remember, quand, when, où, where, pourquoi, why. Same thing here, okay, pourquoi, you should change the order. Okay, so first the verb and then the subject. That's the correct or formal or classic way of asking a question. Pourquoi venez-vous? Venir is to come. So why do you come? Pourquoi venez-vous? Pourquoi venez-vous? All right. Same rule here. If you want to add this est-ce, then you just keep the classic order like subject and verb. Pourquoi est-ce que vous venez? Pourquoi est-ce que vous venez? Okay. And then, comment is how? How? Comment venez-vous? How do you come? Comment venez-vous? Comment venez-vous? Comment est-ce que vous venez? Comment est-ce que vous venez? And then the last one, combien, how much, how many. So in French, we use this combien, how much or how many. Combien de sucre, sucre means sugar. And then voulez-vous, okay, vouloir, to want, okay. So how many sugar do you want? Combien de sucre voulez-vous? Combien de sucre voulez-vous? Combien de sucre voulez-vous? And then same thing here, just add this est-ce. Combien de sucre est-ce que vous voulez? Combien de sucre est-ce que vous voulez? All right. In this lesson, we will count together, yeah, from 20 to 50, de 20 à 50. I hope you're ready because it's starting right now. 20, 21, okay, so remember to make this little link, 21, 21, 22, 22, 23, 23, 24, 24, 25, 25, 26, 26. So remember it's ending with X, but then we pronounce it S, 26. 27, remember set, it was this P disappear, you don't pronounce it. 27, 28, so here you make the liaison. 28, 28, 29, 29, 29. Then here, remember this EN, 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 30. 30, 30. Okay, don't insist on the E, it doesn't exist here. 30, 31, 31, 31, 32, 32, 33, 33. Remember, final S doesn't exist. 33, 34. 34, 34. Remember in French, the rule is that if you start with, well, if you get this combination Q, U, A, well, you will pronounce it K, K. Same thing for the other vowels, okay? So because that's the rule, after vowel, but then this U, well, basically it's not pronounced, okay? So K, 4, 34, 35, 35, 36, 36, 37, 37, 38, 38, 39, 39, 40. Okay, so same rule as previously, as for 4, okay? 40. 40, ok? 41, 41, 42, 42, 43, 43, 44, 44, 45, 45, 46, 46, 47, 47, 48, 48, 49, 49, 50, 50. Same thing here. Okay, remember that you get this Q, U, but then you don't pronounce the U. And then you've got the nasal, un, and then en, 50, 50. Okay? We'll discover together le verbe venir. Venir means to come, okay, to come, so it's quite useful. And then you will have to use it quite often in French. So let's see how you conjugate this verb at the present form, okay, because this verb is not regular. Just wanted to tell you first, okay. So the first form is je viens. Je viens. Okay, remember this I, viens, viens, and then this nasal, final S not pronounced, je viens, tu viens, so it's the same form, okay, tu viens, il, elle, vient, final T not pronounced, il vient, elle vient. So if we take 1 second just to have a look at the je, tu, il, elle forms, they are phonetically the same. Vient, vient, vient. Okay? You write the S, S, T, but then you pronounce these forms the same way. Okay? For nous, it will be different because nous is here. Nous venons. Okay? O, N, S, classical ending for nous. Okay? Final S not pronounced. So O, N, on, venons. Venons, nous venons, nous venons. Okay, and then vous venez. Remember a Z combined like that. Et venez, venez, vous venez. Okay, and then the last form. So remember here, it's quite interesting because we've got this E vowel here, and then we've got a double N after. Okay, and the rule in French is that when you get this E and a double vowel after, you will have to pronounce this E like E, E, all right? So, Vienne, 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 okay? Ils viennent, elles viennent. Ils viennent, elles viennent, all right? E and T, you don't pronounce them. Ils viennent, elles viennent. All right? So, je viens, tu viens, il vient, elle vient, nous venons, vous venez, ils viennent, elles viennent. All right? And in this lesson, we'll discover the questions in which you will find qui, que, or then quoi, okay? So let's discover now qui, okay? Qui means who, okay? So if you want to ask a question regarding someone, like in these two examples, so the first one, who is he? Qui est-il, okay? So remember the formal, the normal way when we start a question with qui, or then as we saw in the previous lessons, okay, you will have to change the order and to put your subject, il, he, here, after the verb. Qui est-il? And then you make the liaison. Qui est-il? Who is he? Qui est-il? Qui est-il? Or then, let's see, a little example here. Qui vient? Vient is venir. Vient is venir, yeah, is to come, sorry. So, qui vient, who is coming, avec toi, with you, ce soir, this evening. Qui vient avec toi ce soir, is coming with you this evening. Qui vient avec toi ce soir, okay? If you pronounce them normally, remember that you will have to raise your voice a little bit at the end of the question. So let's pronounce them the normal way. Qui est-il? Qui vient avec toi ce soir? Okay. Second one is que. So qui, who, que, what. What, okay. And then we'll see two examples here. Que fais-tu? Okay. Fais coming from faire. Faire means to do. Okay. Que fais-tu? What are you doing? What do you do? Okay. Que fais-tu? Same thing here. Remember, que, So you start a question with que, then you get to change the order. You get to put the subject after the verb, okay? Que fais-tu? And it's a question. Que fais-tu? Que fais-tu? Okay. And here, que veux-tu? So veux is coming from vouloir, vouloir to want. Que veux-tu? What do you want? Okay. Que veux-tu? Regarder, regarder is to watch. À la télévision. Well, at the television. Que veux-tu regarder à la télévision? So let's read it normally now. Que veux-tu regarder à la télévision? Que veux-tu regarder à la télévision? Okay, so you can hear that I've been raising a little bit my voice at the end. And then the other option is quoi. So quoi means what as well. So you will tell me, oh, you get two what here. You get que and quoi. Yeah, for a good reason. Look at that. Well, tu fais quoi? So I've been just taking the same question as we had here. This que fais-tu? What do you do? What are you doing? Okay. But then if you're using this quoi, then it does mean that you don't start the question with it. You just put it here, for example, at the end. Okay? Tu fais quoi? It is exactly the same meaning as this question, okay? But then you can see that you just keep the normal order of the sentence, subject, verb, okay? In that case, you definitely need to raise your voice at the end, okay? Tu fais quoi? Tu fais quoi? And then I took the same example as we had here, okay? Tu veux regarder quoi à la télévision, okay? So let's raise the voice at the end to make it clear that it's a question. Tu veux regarder quoi à la télévision? Tu veux regarder quoi à la télévision? Okay, so let's repeat. Qui, who, qui est-il? Qui vient avec toi ce soir? Que, what? But you start the question with it. Que fais-tu? Que veux-tu regarder à la télévision? And then quoi? You don't start the question and it means what? Tu fais quoi? Tu veux regarder quoi à la télévision? Discover together le verbe faire, so the verb to do. Okay, so faire is really useful because we tend to use it quite much in French. Okay, so it's, well, usually quite important to discover this verb at the right beginning. So the verb faire. Je fais. Je fais. Remember, final S not pronounced. Je fais. Tu fais. Same rule here. Final S not pronounced. Tu fait. Il, masculin, and then elle, féminin, fait. Final T, not pronounced. Il, elle, fait. So if we take 1 second, actually you can see that here, here, and here, you get the same phonetical form, so the same form that you will pronounce. Okay, so you get je fais, tu fais, il fait, and then elle fait. It's the same. Okay? Then, nous. So it's quite strange because French people tend to pronounce faisons, okay? So like here, this A-I is not pronounced like normally we should pronounce it like E, but then like E, okay? Nous faisons. Nous faisons. Okay? And then this one is a bit tricky, so you will have to remember that. And it's quite funny because many French people tend to make the mistake and tend to say vous faisiez, okay? But then no. It's vous faites. Vous faites, okay? So remember, final S here is not pronounced, and then this E is not pronounced either. So faites, faites, vous faites. And ils, plural, font, final T not pronounced, font, font, elles font. Okay, so I will repeat the whole thing one more time. Je fais, tu fais, il fait, elle fait, nous faisons, vous faites, ils font, elles font. Will discover la forme négative. So if you want to say that you are not blah 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 doing something, or so the negative form in French. And so the negative form in French is composed of two elements. The first one is ne, and then you get your verb, and right after your verb you will have to put this pas. Okay, so first ne, then the verb. And after that, pas. Okay, we write it P-A-S, okay, but as usual, final S is not pronounced, so it's pas. Okay, remember one thing. In some cases, we will have verbs starting with H, plus a vowel. And in French, H is pronounced. Okay, so for these verbs, E will have to disappear, and it will be written like that. N. Okay, then will come the verb, and after that, doesn't change, it will be pas. All right, so let's see a few examples now. So for ne pas, il parle avec moi. So il parle, he's talking, avec, with, moi, me. Okay, remember this moi. We introduced that in this unit, and it was a pronom tonique, okay? Il parle avec moi. So if you want to put the negative form of this sentence, so remember, first part ne, so before the verb, then you put your verb, parle. Basically, you don't change it, just put it there, parle. And after that, you put the second part, pas, okay? Then you get the sentence, il ne avec moi. And that's it. You've got your negative sentence here. Okay? Let's see now how it will go with an apostrophe pas. Okay? So, nous allons en France. Okay? So, in that case, if you look, you've got the verb aller. Aller means to go. Okay? Nous allons. Nous allons. We are going. Okay? En France, to France. Here, first letter is A. Okay, remember the rule. If it starts with a vowel, like here it is the case, you will have to drop and take away this E form. So that's the reason why we've got this N apostrophe like that. N'allons. Nous n'allons. And then you don't really need to think. You just put this pas after the verb en France. Nous n'allons pas en France. Nous n'allons pas en France. And that's it. Okay, second example here. It's with the verb habiter. Habiter is to live. You know, when you introduce the place where you live. Okay, and then here, I took this example or this verb just because, of course, it's starting with H, but as I said, you don't pronounce it. So the first sound you hear here is the vowel. And that's enough just to drop and to take away this E. So you will basically make it like in this example, you will put this N apostrophe. Elle n'habite pas dans cette maison. So elle habite, she lives or she is living, dans, in this house. Elle habite dans cette maison, and then negative form, elle n'habite pas dans cette maison. Lesson will work on les adjectifs démonstratifs. So, les adjectifs démonstratifs, in English, it would be this or these, okay? But then, as usual in French, we've got the difference between the masculine, the feminine, and the plural, okay? So we'll see that. So for the masculine form, it will be ce, ce, and then it will be cet, cet, okay? So as usual in French, remember, it can be tricky if a letter, an adjective like that, for instance, is ending, or it could be an article, is ending with a, okay? Just because for some words starting with a vowel or with ash plus a vowel, then we will have to modify it, okay? And that's the reason why here we've got set, okay? But then it's still the masculine form, se, set. For the feminine, it will be set, so only one, set. And then for the plural form, it will be se. Okay, so let's see that again, se, or then set, feminin set. So you can notice that phonetically, these two are pronounced the same way. Okay, set here, and then set here. And for the plural, se, se. Really open this, se. Okay, so let's see a few examples now. The first one, so I did take this train. Train is train, okay, so it's masculine. So it starts with D, so no problem. You will put this ce train, okay? It would be translated like this train, ce train, okay? Here you've got ordinateur. So ordinateur, a computer, okay, and it's masculine. Un ordinateur, okay? But if you look carefully, it starts with O, okay? So vowel, and then you will have to take this set form, so the masculine form, but the one that we'll use with the words that start with vowels, or then H plus voyelle, okay? So set ordinateur, this computer, set ordinateur, okay? And then here, we've got the word homme, man, okay, but then it starts with H, as in French, H is not pronounced, so the first sound that we hear is O, okay, and then it will follow the same rule. You'll have to use the masculine adjective démonstrative, but this form, cet homme, cet homme. All right, femme, woman, cette femme, this woman. Cette femme, cette femme. Okay, and then the last one, personne, persons, pluriel, ces personnes, ces personnes. Cet ordinateur, cet homme, cette femme, ces personnes. In this lesson, we'll just focus on a short thing quite useful, les présentations. Okay, so the first thing, when you meet someone and you want to know the name of this person, well, that's the common question or the normal question that you will have to use. Comment, so how, vous, appelez-vous? Okay, we've been seeing in unit one, if my memory is correct, the verb s'appeler, so to call oneself. Okay, when you introduce yourself, you use this s'appeler verb. Okay, so that's the reason why it will look this way. Comment vous appelez-vous? So what's your name? How are you calling yourself? If you want a direct translation, but it sounds a bit strange in English, but then that's the question. Comment vous appelez-vous? All right. The other possibility that we've got is to keep the normal order. So, vous vous appelez, and then we put this comment thing at the end of the question. Okay. So, in that case, remember to raise your voice at the end. Vous vous appelez comment? Vous vous appelez comment? Okay. So, it is exactly the same question. Okay. It is a bit less formal. this second option, okay? Because the first one is the classic option that we've got. We start with how, and then we change the order. We put the subject after the verb, okay? But then it is, completely correct to ask a question like that. Vous vous appelez comment, okay? And then the other possibility would be, quel est votre nom? What is your votre nom? Name. What is your name? Quel est votre nom? Quel est votre nom? Raise a little bit. Quel est votre nom? Okay, so let's see them one more time. Comment vous appelez-vous? Vous vous appelez comment? Quel est votre nom? All right. In the first example, we've been using this vous form, so the polite form that normally we should use when we meet a person for the first time, okay? But then let's be frank, that if you're young and if you're meeting other young persons, then you can use this tu form, so the less formal way, okay? So the question will look like that. Comment tu t'appelles? Comment tu t'appelles? Okay, well then, same option that we've got. Tu t'appelles comment? So you put this comment at the end, okay? Don't forget to raise your voice because it's a beautiful question here. Tu t'appelles comment? Tu t'appelles comment? And then, quel est ton nom? What is your name? Quel est ton nom? Or other options. So I've been putting this option for this tu, okay, you, the less formal one, and not for the vous, because it is quite spoken this way. C'est quoi ton nom? Well, if you want to translate it directly, it's what your name, okay? It looks really, or it sounds really strange in English, but still it's possible in French. It is not formal at all, of course, okay? So don't use that if it's quite important or if the situation is quite formal, okay? C'est quoi ton nom? C'est quoi ton nom? Okay. Remember, we're using this appeler, s'appeler, okay, to call oneself, okay? Je m'appelle Vincent Lefrançois. Je m'appelle Vincent Lefrançois. Okay? I call myself Vincent Lefrançois. All right? But then that's the way we use to present ourselves, okay? Other option would be to use, not to use this s'appeler to call oneself, but to use to be, which is totally possible. Je suis Vincent Lefrançois. Je suis Vincent Lefrançois. I am, okay? Je suis Vincent Lefrançois. And then, third option, mon nom, my name, okay? Mon nom est, is, mon nom est Vincent Lefrançois. Mon nom est Vincent Lefrançois. Okay, so let's see them one more time. Je m'appelle Vincent Lefrançois. Je suis Vincent Lefrançois. Mon nom est Vincent Lefrançois.